To change the air filter in your Silverado or GMC truck, you have a screw right there that needs to be removed. It's easy to do. You have another screw right there. It's easy to do. And you have another screw right there that's easy to do. So one, two, three. So when you undo this screw right here, you don't have to take it all the way out. What you want to do is basically just loosen it up a little bit so that the pressure on this band can be easier. And then you're going to just pull it off. And it's going to be a little bit of a struggle, but it'll do it. And you want to keep everything clean as possible. So there you go. So I got that off. Now I'm going to take this piece and scoot it. And I got that piece off. I'm going to just wiggle this. And it'll come off. You just got to wiggle a little bit. You don't want to take it completely off. Just put it up there like that. And just to recap, loosen that up a little bit, and then this unit, I kind of jiggled it. I didn't have to depress the tabs. I'll show you the tabs. Here is my air filter, and I'm just going to take it out. And that's how it looks, big deal. And so your air filter will look like that, and you're going to look at the shape of it, I say. And then it'll fit right into the bottom there. Whoa. You could, let's see here. And you always want to inspect the box down there to make sure it's clean. But it's going to fit right in just like that. Top piece back on. You want to make sure that you get these three tabs. One, two, three. You want to make sure you get those three tabs into the slots. One, two, three, right there. It's not hard to do. You just got to have two hands to do it. And then we're going to put this piece on at the very end. And you just put a little pressure on it. You'll know when you have it correct because the tabs will go in there. It takes two hands, and I'm pulling it like this. So let me put that in perspective here. So I'm pulling it to the tabs, pulling it this way. And then I'm going to visually inspect my tabs to make sure that it looked just like it did when I started. And now I go back. I want to make sure this piece is just like it was whenever I took it off. It's going to take a little bit of finagling, but don't give up. And you're saving yourself a lot of money, and you're doing it the right way. See, it takes two hands to push it back up in place. You definitely want to make sure it's snug, because you don't want this coming off and getting any garbage in your vehicle. Make sure it's snug. I'm using this hand right here to push that way as I tighten. And you don't want to bear down on this. You don't want to crimp anything or bend anything, but you want to make sure it's tight. There you go. So now what I have to do is put the three screws back in place, and that's going to be easy to do. I'll show you where they were in the beginning of the video. We might do a recap on a second. But this is one air filter that you can be using, and I'll have a link down below so you can buy it. A lot of people like K&N, a lot of people like AC Delco. This is from Walmart of all places. Okay, great, Walmart. Okay, so now I'm going to put the three screws back in place and be done with it. If you're still watching, you're a smart person. I'll tell you why. This screw right here on this side, let me zoom out so you get perspective, is probably the most difficult to put in just because you have these things in your way. You don't want to use a screwdriver on that part. Reach your hand in around the back side and start to tighten it that way. Otherwise, your screw could fall like mine did. If the screw falls, just play with this a little bit, bang on it, and that's where my screw was and it fell out. So extra bonus feature for you.